The United States has always insisted that it takes reports about civilian casualties very seriously, especially when we ask them about such reports.
What does the number of civilian deaths have to be for you to call it disturbing?
We always seek to minimize civilian casualties in any kind of operation, military operation, airstrike that we carry out.
The U.S. strike that reportedly killed around 20 civilians in the ISIL-held city of Manbij in Syria, was it a mistake? On Monday.
That's another great accusatory question you've asked here. No other military works as hard as ours. None. No other military in the world to prevent civilian casualties.
Those words sound absolutely certain, but a new report indicates that things aren't always as Washington insists they are. Columbia Law School Human Rights Institute oversees the Center for Civilians in Conflict. They have conducted 228 different investigations into civilian casualties in Iraq, Syria, and Afghanistan. Now, they looked into how the U.S. military carries out these investigations, and they determined that when investigating itself, the U.S. military can be rather inconsistent.
Military leaders have publicly acknowledged the value of investigating allegations of civilian harm. However, over the last 18 years, examples of good practice in investigating civilian harm have been overshadowed by the inconsistency of the overall record of military investigations.
For example, when investigating civilian casualties, U.S. officials rarely ever visit the scene of the crime. In only 16% of cases do they actually go to the site of the attack. And they rarely ever interview witnesses either. Only 21.5% of cases involve interviews with eyewitnesses.
In too many instances, investigations have been concluded based on incomplete or inadequate internal information, or have failed to sufficiently incorporate external evidence.
Not to sound like Sherlock Holmes here, but if you never interview any witnesses and you never visit the scene of the crime, how exactly do you go about investigating an incident? Well, here is a standard civilian casualties report.
Out of the 52 completed casualty allegation reports, 4 reports were determined to be credible and resulted in 12 unintentional civilian deaths. Combined Joint Task Force Operation Inherent Resolve assessed the remaining 48 reports as non-credible.
That word, non-credible, is key to everything. If a flight log or strike record is incomplete, the entire incident gets chucked. The Pentagon says that more than 1,190 civilians died as a result of U.S. airstrikes in Iraq and Syria. However, a monitoring group says that number is actually 7,438, 5 times higher. Now, this all may sound shocking, but think about it. What criminal would ever be caught doing wrong if they were in charge of their own investigation? Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.